Dear friends, welcome back. This is Nick from educate.tv and today we're going to see how to control our 4W Cob LED with Arduino. Without any further delay, let's get started. These LEDs are very popular and low cost nowadays, so I thought it would be a good idea to learn how to control them with Arduino. So I built a simple project that simply turns on a 4W Cob LED when the button is pressed. When the button is pressed again, the LED turns off. The LED is powered by a 12-volt battery and it is controlled by the Arduino using a MOSFET. But let's see how to build it. The parts needed in order to build this project are these: an Arduino, a 4W Cob LED or similar, a MOSFET module, a boost converter, a constant current driver, a push button, and a 12-volt battery or power supply. The cost of the project, if you exclude the battery, is about 10 euros. You can find links for all the parts in the description of the video. Before we start, I would like to warn you that you have to be very careful when you are working with voltages over 12 volts. Misuse of tools or materials can cause injury and mismanagement of electricity can cause electric shock or explosion. I do not take responsibility for the consequences of making the project shown in this video. Proceed at your own risk. This LED works best at about 15 volts. So, in order to achieve that, we have to raise the voltage of the 12-volt battery to about 15 volts. For that, we are going to use this boost converter module. With this potentiometer, we can change the output voltage of it. I set it to 15 volts and we can move on. Next, we have to limit the amount of current that runs through the LED in order to avoid overheating and destruction of it. In order to achieve that, we are going to use this constant current and voltage driver. This module has three potentiometers. The first one sets the voltage limit. We set it to 15 volts using a multimeter. Next, we change the third potentiometer in order to set the current limit to about 250 milliamps. Be careful to set up your multimeter correctly in order to avoid destruction of it. That's it. If we now connect the LED to the battery via these two modules, it will light up very brightly. But if we want to control the LED with an Arduino, we are going to need the MOSFET module. Think of it as a digital switch intended for high voltages and currents. This MOSFET module can handle up to 24 volts and 5 amps, so it is well suited for this project. We connect the output of the constant current module to the input of the module. Then we connect the LED to the output of the MOSFET module. Now all we have to do is to connect the MOSFET module with the Arduino Uno board in order to control it. The connection with Arduino is very easy. We connect ground to Arduino ground, VCC to Arduino 5 volts, and lastly we connect the signal pin to digital pin 10 of the Arduino Uno. Next, we connect a push button to Arduino. One leg of the button goes to ground and the other goes to digital pin 2. That's it. Now we are able to control the LED with Arduino. Be careful, this particular LED gets hot quickly, so we need a heatsink if we want to have it on for a long period of time. But we will get to that in a future video. Let's take a quick look now at the code of the project. As you can see, the code of the project is really simple. All we do is we read the state of the button. If the button is pressed once, we write high to digital pin 10, which is connected to the MOSFET module. If we press the button again, we write low to digital pin 10, and this way we turn off the LED. As always, you can find the code of the project in a link in the description of the video. As you can see, controlling an LED with Arduino is very easy. The same procedure applies to other 12-volt devices as well, like this siren. I am going to combine this siren with an LED, a PIR sensor, a TS3231 real-time clock and a Bluetooth module in order to build a simple security system which will be solar-powered, so stay tuned. What other features do you think we can add to the Arduino-powered security system? Please post your comments or ideas in the comments section below. If this is your first time here, I would love to have you subscribed. In this channel, I post videos about do-it-yourself projects every Saturday. I love making things and I believe that anyone can make things, anyone can become a maker. That's why I created this channel, in order to share my knowledge with the community and learn from the community. I hope you will join us. Until next Saturday, watch, learn, build.